yourself in and join us for the making of Godsmack 5.
This is Sully from Godsmack on location on our new video shoot, Crying Like a Bitch. We want to thank you and everybody at iTunes for all your support for Godsmack and our new single, Crying Like a Bitch. Peace.
From the top, here we go, Ignacio, and playback, please.
This broadcast. We're back on. All right, we're gonna take this thing back to the beginning. We're gonna start over. And this time we're gonna do it different.
Let me just tell you what bums me out about full stacks is that amps become taller than the musicians.
Gotcha.
And then it just feels like he's a bit dwarfed in front of it sometimes. For me, anyways, where everything else looks low profile. I don't care. It's not killing me. It's not bothering me that much for me to want to, you know, do it. I just thought that could be a little bit better of a look. Yeah.
Time ain't on your side anymore. And so
I'm going to bore it here just in case I decide to clean and not do two full sleeves.
Oh, yeah.
I may want to, you know, leave this one like this and maybe take this and go this way. But I do want to do, I've been thinking, I do want to border this here, like now, with something solid. I don't know if I'm going to do, like, my daughter's name and a couple people that I love, like, in a script. But either way, I do want it, I don't want it to go down too much further. I just kind of want to get a piece that seals this off and It doesn't border like that.
My chances, but I've told you one too many times and you were crying like a bitch.
Listen, Here's my replacement right here.
He spent 4 months filming him. It's the most he's talked to you ever.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. This is the guy right here that's taking my job.
Yeah.
We're going to have a guitar off right now to see who gets the gig.
I like to smash mine first, though.
Huh?
I smash my guitar first, then I play.
See, I'm never going to win. He's got way more attitude than me.
It's gonna move. I did it in the wake video. I hung it from a cage. It's all over the place. I mean, it's cool to grab it, but when it goes, but it's kind of cool when it swings, you know what I mean? But if you're looking for that one shot. I'll have to do it when we're not in the middle of like a performance, because once I hit it, it's like hot.
All over, yeah.
Yeah, so you gotta come up a little bit.
Okay.
Yeah, like to there.
Pulled it off my fireplace 2 days ago. Fireplace, and it hangs up there. And I grabbed it off and took it and cleaned all the dust off it. It hasn't been played in a year.
It's stronger than you can be. Oh, stronger than you can be.
All I know is it looks wicked good. Did you see the playback yet?
It looks really good.
So good. This is gonna be killer with the UFC flip.
Stronger than you can.
Like a it's a photo shoot like anything else. It's just a long day of standing there trying to like not blink. It sounds stupid to say. It's really exhausting to stand there and go through a photo shoot and have that flash bulb flash in your face about 9,000 times.
When will it ever end and when will my life begin?
Paul Brown was the photographer that day, and he's somebody that we've worked with since the first record. He's a great photographer, he's a great artist. He's done a lot of our album covers, he's done a bunch of our photos in the past. He's a really good guy, you know, we've had long relationships with a lot of the people we work with, and Paul's one of them. And the funny thing was, is the band wasn't in a really good place when we all kind of met up. We hadn't really been talking in a little while. There was a little bit of static, you know, that had happened between the time the record was done being recorded and the time we met up for the photo shoot, so the whole day was just a little bit slightly uncomfortable, I think, for everybody, you know. I was definitely feeling some negative vibes off of Tony, for sure.
Yeah. It almost makes three rings like the Olympic side.
All right, I need your help.
And a few times Paul Brown came to me and he's like, I need some help with Tony, like, fuck. We gotta get him to do something, change a position or whatever. I said, bro, this is your job, man. You're the director here. You fucking tell him what you need, because I'm just here to do my part, and then I'm going home. This is some of the bullshit that, you know, that I deal with, but it's their prerogative, you know? It's however they want to look is fine with me. I don't really care anymore. I just try to be there and show up and do my part. You know, what are you going to do, man? No one's perfect, you know? We've said it a million times. Brothers love each other and brothers fight. You know, it's not always a great day, but every day is a good day. We'll see what happens in the next few weeks when we all get together and talk some more. Maybe we can iron shit out, maybe we can't. Maybe you're seeing the last of Godsmack right now and you don't even fucking know it. You never know, man. Life is unpredictable. We can't tell the future. All we can do is get up in the morning and just track through a different day.